Hello and welcome to The Telescope. Every week we'll bring you a fresh insight from the biggest car market in the world. Today we're discussing the upcoming Baojun Cloud. It is a Volkswagen ID.3 sized half SUV, half MPV crossover. It is expected to start around $15,000. Isn't that amazing? It might be the cheapest full-function electric vehicle money can buy. Yes, the telescope has covered quite a lot of much cheaper EVs from China, but all of them are kind of the second or the third car. Their ridiculously cheap price makes you forgive their limited performance or range. But if you only have the budget or the room to fit one car, the Baojun Cloud could be that cheapest choice. I need to point out that this is under the July 2023 exchange rate. At this moment in time, everything looks amazingly cheap from an American's point of view. We're here to have an educated guess on how will Baojun execute this car, because at nearly 4.3 meters long, the Baojun Cloud cannot be those ultra-cheap electric vehicles with limited performance. It needs to do everything, go everywhere, keep up with everyone else, and has an acceptable range. So far looks like it can. From the homologation info posted on MIIT's website, the Baojun Cloud measures at 42.95mm long, 18.50mm wide, and 16.52mm tall. That is 70mm longer, 72mm wider, and 84mm taller than the Volkswagen ID.3 behind me. Let's start on the longitudinal space, or in other words, the all-important knee room. I predict the Baojun Cloud will have pretty similar knee room compared to the ID.3, because yes, Baojun Cloud's wheelbase is 65mm shorter, but will probably have the torsion beam rear suspension, which is more space efficient, instead of the more sophisticated multi-link setup on the ID.3. How do I know this? Baojun has been openly posting pictures showing they are studying the competition. The two cars they're comparing against are the BYD Dolphin and the Ion Y. Both of them are on torsion beam rear suspension, and the materials released so far don't have a word about chassis performance. If the Baojun Cloud is on multi-link rear suspension, we definitely would have heard it by now. By having 80mm extra rear overhang, that is, this part, I expect the Baojun Cloud to have a much bigger boot than the ID.3. The ID.3's boot is already at a very respectable 385 litres, not small by hatchback standard. But even if we assume the same rear floor height for both, I expect the Baojun Cloud's boot to be around 425 litres, just by that extra 80mm in rear overhang. And Baojun might have an extra trick up its sleeve. We have already seen the ultra-deep underfloor storage on the Wuling Bingo. That car's boot isn't amazing in length, but it has a very low floor. If you can stack your things on top of each other, then it becomes much more useful. And the Baojun Cloud's electric motor is front-mounted, so it could free up even more space for the boot. Who knows? We are guessing here. It would be also very interesting to see how will Baojun spend the extra 84mm in height. I suspect most of it will be spent on giving it a higher seating position, because the current height of the Baojun Cloud is near identical to the much bigger Ion Y. Onto performance, the Baojun Cloud will have a front-mounted 100kW motor. That is right in between the 70kW motor in the BYD Dolphin and the 125kW motor on the China-spec Volkswagen ID.3. Because the Baojun Cloud is similar in weight to the ID.3 and they have the same tyre width, front motor, so slightly less traction under acceleration. I expect the acceleration of the Baojun Cloud to be around 9 seconds, which is definitely not fast, but it's an electric vehicle, no gear change needed, instant in-gear response, so should be enough for a family car. On range, it's already been made public that the Baojun Cloud will have two spec. The smaller battery has 37.9 kWh and is rated at 360 km. The bigger battery has 50.6 kWh and is rated at 460 km CLTC. That translates to about 400 km WLTP and about 220 miles EPA. However, I am slightly curious on how is the Baojun Cloud achieving 10 kilometers more range under the CLTC cycle with 3.4 kWh less battery capacity and a much bigger frontal area. I mean, it's wider and taller than the ID.3. But I guess I'll find out soon enough. The Baojun Cloud will also have all the lane keep ADAS functions. At this moment, I would like to remind you that this is a car that starts at just $15,000. An ADAS function is provided by a very well-known brand on YouTube. DJI. Yes, all of their know-how accumulated in their drone's collision avoid functions comes in handy when they want to become a Tier 1 ADAS supplier. Actually, DJI already provided the ADAS kit for the beloved Baojun Yap, but the modest hardware on that means it only works up to 80 kilometers an hour.
Now this system is designed to work at low speed. This car's top speed is only 100 kph. So what I'm going to do now is activate the system, and you can see a blue line shows up on this screen, and I can increase the speed to 60 kilometers an hour. It's a red light in front. Let's see whether it will brake. It's braking the car to a standstill. I mean, this is respectable ACC and lane keep performance.
This time on the Baojun Cloud, the lane keep and ACC will work all the way up to 130 kph. We even heard potentially it could memorize your daily routine after you drive it multiple times, scan its own map, and form a customized ADAS route. We will reserve judgment on that when they deliver this to customers. We don't have any official interior images. Actually, scratch that. As we're editing this video, Baojun released footage of the seats. It doesn't look like any $15,000 car. The rear seat can recline up to 135 degrees. I'm not too keen on a dark green color, but let's wait until the real car. One thing I constantly hear people doubt about cheap Chinese EVs is safety. You should know that China has the same 25% small front overlap crash test as Europe and the United States, even on the passenger side. The only difference is Euro NCAP recently raised the speed of the side impact test, so more energy going through the structure. Europe has more specific auto emergency braking test items, and the United States has tougher roof strength test. What I'm trying to get across is China's safety standard, while isn't world leading, is not a joke either. Nowadays, the safety simulation software is so accurate, really it's not about whether the manufacturer can produce a safe car or not, it's about whether they want to. Overall, the Baojun Cloud looks like the real deal. Because the lower spec version has a smaller battery, it has a genuine chance of matching the starting price of the base spec BYD Dolphin. For size, space, performance, interior, this is the next level. You're only losing 40 kilometers range, which is definitely noticeable, but not unmanageable. The BYD Dolphin is currently selling like crazy, nearly 30,000 units consistently every month, which I suspect is the current production capacity ceiling. How much of that can be stolen by the Baojun Cloud? We should not forget that the bigger, more expensive IONY could be under pressure as well. We should get an early peek at the Baojun Cloud soon enough. As a consumer, I'm very glad to see that cheap cars are getting better. That is all from the telescope today. If you enjoyed this video, keep watching, keep subscribing. More videos coming along very soon.